Hi, this is Kevin with KDM Jam, owner of Pro Advertisers Club, a totally free site to advertise. Go to proadvertisersclub.com, join for free today, and start advertising for free. Okay, here we are into the first, the combat stage, already in battle, and let's see how we're doing so far. We got all the phrase filled, so we're in good shape. 39 battles out of 55 have already been fought. It looks like almost everybody's put their teams in. We still got a few people who haven't. And overall, we're in first place still. Fantastic. 70 wins and 12 losses. Yeah, filling those phrase are absolutely a must now. So that's another rule change that they've made that's actually benefited us. And sometimes they do and sometimes they don't. So if you have not joined a guild yet, I got one spot left open, but right now we don't have enough phrase for the amount of people we have, but there's a couple people who aren't showing up, like Doge is probably on his way out. He's got four accounts in here, and I don't know why he disappeared, but he has. And then there's one more probably. So more than likely, you'll still be able to get in and get a fray if one's needed. Let's go real quick and look at the numbers. And not looking good. It's been another downturn today. There's my gold account, regular foil. Buy, sell, and rent. 500 for the five properties I got. 302 for SPS for total. Value of 3,933, down from an all-time high of probably 4,600. So I'm down about $600. But as far as in profit, I'm down a whopping 50% probably. I had an all-time high there of 1,500 almost. So yeah, I'm down about 60% over the last few days. It just took a hard hit all of a sudden. But what does that mean? That means it's good for DCAing. And I have $10 ready to go. So we're going to do that in a second. Let's go do the land. Or actually, let's go do the, I want to show you the Buzz YouTubers. Right here's a list, I call them the Buzz Group. This is everybody who makes Splinterlands content. So if you have not already, please go like and subscribe and support them as best as you can. I know it's, especially if they all put out videos in the same day, it gets kind of rough. But just go do the best you can. It helps them and it helps you as we promote Splinterlands on YouTube, trying to catch that algorithm. Bugs, Bags, and Caps over there on Twitch is another one. Here's all their links. You can pause this and get the links if you need it to go do so. And some make more than others, so, you know, that's just the way it is. Bronze Dragon, every Saturday morning, he has a stream at 11:30 a.m. After Sound, Tuesday, Thursdays, and Sundays. Splinter Zone, once or twice a week. Peace Silence, every Thursday on Twitch at 9 p.m. SHQ, they stream whenever they do. That's a pretty good one. You need to check it out. SteveR82, about once a week. People's Guild, one or two a week. And Boba Fett, usually about one or two a week. So if you're not on this list and you need to get on it for streaming and the time, please send it to me and I'll put you on there. So thank you for everything everybody's doing to promote the site. So production. This is my land. First property here. I got five total. This one just mines for or grows grain. So all I'm going to do is harvest it and then stack it, which it does that automatically. I got almost 300,000 grain. And we're going to be able to sell it. I don't know if I'm going to. I don't know if there's going to be a market for it initially until 2.0 comes out. So I'll just keep stacking it. Yeah, I'm almost at 300,000. Okay, the next one also does grain, but it does enough for itself and for all the other properties. So what I would do now is claim this, pay the tax, which is basically grain feeding the workers. Then I'll go back. And now let's go up to here and transfer it over to the property that needs it the most. And I just put in 9270. I don't stack grain on this property because I don't need to. And it looks like 46 thallus. I got two properties in that track. Tracks share the same grain silo. So I'll send it on over to that. So I'm good to go for the next few days. I claim twice a day, once in the morning and once at night. All right, let's go back and claim the last three properties. Now this next one is going to be research points. And right now all you can do is collect them, but it's a mining building. It's mining research points. Pay the grain. And what we're going to use them for is kind of, we're going to need them. Just don't know exactly how much and what for exactly. I mean, I'm not going to delve into it until they actually come out with it. And then the other thing we can do is mine SPS right now. And that's what I'm doing on my last two properties. I do not spend SPS. I accumulate and stack and wait. I'm playing the long game with it. Now over on the Hive Engine, I sold a bunch of my Chaos Legion, the Gladius cards that I wasn't using, especially the gold cards, because I only got one of them. And as a collector, yeah, that was nice to have, but I'm figuring I can buy them back in later on if there's any left. They might be so out of reach, I don't know. But I got like $90 for it. Actually, $120 I got for it, you know, all in DEC, of course. But I converted that. I took care of some business with it as far as with the guild. Excuse me. And then with the remaining $40, I bought SPS. Because SPS is so low right now. Let's go check. I got no totem piece that claim. And it is down to 2.17 cents. So let's go and claim what I got. Throw that on the pile. But now that SPS on the Hive Engine, I might flip back. And if it's not worth it to do that, I'll just send it over and stake it. So either way, you know, it'll work out good. But that's the only time. Okay, let's stake the 5 SPS that I got up here. So I'm earning SPS in several different ways. I'm earning it from land rewards, which I just claimed. And that's whatever, you know, you saw me claim. It's probably about 10 a day, maybe 15. Nightmare rewards is the nightmare packs for the tower defense game coming out. Every 13 packs, thank you, Gather the Magic, for figuring that out, equals 1 SPS. So I'm getting about 6 SPS now for all mine. I'm going to buy another pack today. I don't have a license, which is a node. But then my battle rewards, I get them, and I get them out of my chest right now, which will end at the end of the season. And then I also get it for the 13.63 APR for staking. So there's a lot of ways to earn SPS right now. These proposals are driving me nuts. There's been so many. I can't keep track of them. I don't want to go read them all. So I've been basically listening to After Sound, Bronze Dragon, and Gathering the Magic whenever they make one. Bronze Dragon did a real good one the night before. And I'm just having a hard time keeping track of them. So I kind of go with the rest of the group. Require KYC for DAO sponsored tournaments. You know what? Yeah, KYC, I have to do it, you have to do it. How's that mentality? Now, some people might argue that would keep whatever, but you know what? I'd rather get good quality players. The numbers are great when you can get a lot of people to join, but if they don't play or they don't participate, it really doesn't do any good. And somebody willing to KYC for anything is pretty serious about doing it. So I'm going with yes on that. I'm not into getting, you know, a lot of signups and a lot of people that don't want to play the game or participate. Not interested in that. But there's been like 20 pre-proposals and proposals over the last week or so. And it's very hard to keep track of, for me anyway. Let's go to the battle page. And we'll go look at my... And I got a show you a battle I did last night. Here's the four chests. I got some SPS, some cards, and some legendary, a lot of legendary potions. So let's go down here, see if I can find it. I actually recognize somebody I fought. Aftersound right there. And he beat me. Let's go look at the battle. Aftersound 3. Now, I know he plays in Modern. I think he does. So let's rumble. Let's see how bad he... But he's not using anything spectacular. I mean, this is something I don't see too much. And this guy always kicks my ass. I love this guy. He does... Whenever he's in the lineup, he seems to kick my ass. But there's no healing, and I forgot about that. So that I kind of screwed myself with the load-ups, but... I'm not doing too well. Now, this was me. This was not my bot. I'm in Wild, and I use Splinter Mate for $1 a month. Yeah, I'm not... He totally kicked my ass on this one. Even with the rebirth. But I never got past this guy. That's a strong... This is showing you somebody that really knows how to line them up. You know what I'm saying? And if you study that, you can learn from this. That's an absolute powerful lineup. So, congratulations, Aftersound, for kicking my ass. All right, I got an actual battle I can go do. Now, the way Splinter Mage is set up, you can jump in anytime you want. And the bot will just take over if you're not around. And then there's a pause button. You can go pause it and build. Like, if you want to go to bed and wake up in the morning and play a bunch of games, you can go pause it and there'll be, you know, if you 10 hours, there's 10 games that you can do. All right, I'm going to try. I'd love to use the obsidian. Oh, shit. I can't use my eyeball guy. But I can use... Holy shit, look at these guys. One, two. I definitely want to use all three of those. I've got to get the healer in there. And let's see if there's anything else I'd rather use. So many cards. I like to use this guy. And I like to use her. So I'm going to get rid of the Tractor Hulks. And that will leave me with 6 of 7. So I can do another 4. And then a 3. Alright, I got him in the back. I'm going to put the back here. Put the Mad Caps right here. Give him time. And then I got Kron in this. I'm going to put him back here also. All right, let's battle. Let's see what happens. You see how long it took me to put that together? I think it was Steve RE2. He claims that if you take 3 minutes to put a team together, you're using a battle helper. Trust me, I need one, but I'm not using one. You just saw me do it. All right, who am I playing? It's a look. Here's the what I'm eighth level. I'm playing against second. Doesn't mean I'm going to win. I've gotten my ass kicked by first level, but I can use all my maxed out cards. So I'm really enjoying the new. And damn, I lost. How in the hell did that happen? Oh, good. The arrow guy. That little arrow guy. Even though he doesn't got a lot of hit points, he kicks my ass a lot. Shit, I'm getting my ass kicked here. Oh, good. That helped. Might win this one. Looks like I am. Here we go. Fantastic. But another situation where the new rules are helping me big time. Some people it's not. They're very upset, I guess. But, let's see what my ranking is. Leaderboard. I'm 6971. I'm currently in gold 3, working my way to gold 2. And we still got 12 days to go in the, and I've already got 2 chests for nice. Okay, there we go. Let's go and start the DCA. All you people who are making videos about the proposals, thank you. That's you know. I just don't get into that stuff, especially all the jargon and. All right, let's go and do the packs. What I'm going to get first? I'm going to get one nightmare pack. Now you can't open these yet, but you get SPS for every one SPS for every 13 it comes out to about. Okay, there's that. I got 77 packs and climbing. Should I do another rebellion pack? I've really been wanting to do a Rift Watchers. But yeah, I might as well do it while I got the potions. Once the potions aren't in chest no more, I'll probably never buy another potion again. Because I'd rather use it towards the cards. I don't know. We'll see. I got to see what it's like everybody else. And then let's buy a Chaos Legion pack. So there's already a little bit over half of my DCA, but I like to open packs. And I still get a nice spread of cards. Now, is it better to go directly after you want than trying to get them in packs? Yeah, definitely. Unless, of course, you get something real good, then you look like a genius, right? But, all right, let's go over to the card cells and get my daily alpha card. Let's see what the cheapest one is today, and it's the Fire Beetle again, and it's going for 50 cents, so I will get one of them. And you're like, well, why are you doing, you know, what's the big deal? Well, I'm trying to max out alpha cards. I want to max out. I'm trying to buy the cheapest one I can get that I don't have every day. And I don't have any of them maxed out, but it's working its way up. And plus, alpha cards are probably going to be, you know, some of the rarest cards on the platform in a few years. I mean, this is a common, and there's only 4,713 left of those. Now, there are 4,000 packs left, but that's nothing. That's not hardly anything, because especially since people probably won't open them, they'll keep them, you know. What did I just do? Oh, I went over to the How can I not have any ohms? Oh, that's the alpha. Okay, let's go back to the market. So now I'm going to go and get my daily gold card. And all I do is I go to the cheap one that I don't have maxed out and is the cheapest. And let's check out. I think I finished him yesterday. Yeah, he's maxed out. So I'm done with that one. This one's maxed out. This one's maxed out. I don't know if this one's maxed out. No. So I definitely am about halfway there. So let's go to the market and buy. What do I got left? $3 and... And they're basically, let's get this one to 23 cents. Let's get a dollar's worth. And we'll get 50 cents worth. Because I want to get some summoners. That will give me 16. I thought I had 18. All right, now I'm going to go get the summoners. I've got the gold summoners maxed out. I've got the... So I don't need to go after those. On the five splinters out of Chaos Legion... They're not the best summoners, but they are. I think they're the best bang for the buck. Okay, I've got her maxed out. And I've got General Sloan maxed out. Boy, he dropped. Look how cheap he got. Damn. See, this is the nice part of DCAing. Is if they get cheaper. But unfortunately, the two I've already done have gotten even cheaper than when I was buying them. So I've got $2.84. And I can get these five at 45 cents a piece. For 224, and let's see if I got enough for one more. I do. Okay, so I'm getting a total of six of them for today. Let's go and... Now, I'm not worried about that timer because when I go to combine these to the ones over on the Taro Cabot account, it's going to erase that because if you put it to a larger group, it just wipes it out. Otherwise, I couldn't use it for a few days. Okay, we'll send that over there. And I'm going to keep my... here because of all the potions I got. So let's open that one first. And then I'll just transfer them over later. Alright, here we go. Come on, gold. Come on, legendary. Come on, potions. Nada. This is an average pack. No legendaries, but I could have a gold still. And I'm hoping that rare is a summoner. And it's not. Okay. But I can add those two. I'll do that later on. Alright, same thing with the rebellion. Got an epic. Nice. Okay, so it's a little bit above average pack. No legendaries, but let's see if I get a gold. Come on, gold. Especially as an epic. No, but it is a pretty decent card. I don't think I have that one. So we shall see here in a second. Let's go combine them. It's got Rebellion. I have no summon. Yeah, I do. I got a summoner combined right there. Okay, go back. Get rid of the summoners. Let's do the epics. These are all my epics. And I already had that, so... go look at the rares. I didn't get any rares today. They're all commons. So I got four more to combine. Starting with this one. Now this is, I don't know, you know, the pack right now, unless you get something good, you're kind of not getting your $3 back. But I think that one I did with the the epic. Yeah, because like these are only 11 cents right here. But, you know, you're going for those gold legendaries and stuff like that. So, a pack can be worth it if you get lucky. All right, there's that. So, now let's go look at my wagons and call it a day. I still got four slots left, so I don't need to get another wagon yet. I'm buying them as I need them, kind of spreading it out. And we got 2 days left, so I'm going to end up with probably 65, maybe. Maybe, I don't know. Outside chance I get one, small chance. So anyway, thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe. If you get a chance, go to Pro Advertisers Club and check that out. If you haven't joined a guild yet, please do so. It's the amount, if you want the rewards, what you get on the platform, is the guild's probably the best from, you know, day in and day out. And especially as we get higher. Now, I do have one spot left, maybe more. I'm about to kick some people out. But just send an invite or a request and I'll send you an invite. And also, if you haven't joined Splinterlands yet, if you're just checking this out, wondering what the hell I'm doing, and something seems like you're interested in, go join this. Join, help us grow this platform, support it. And they're on their sixth year. And thank you for watching. I know your time's valuable. Have a nice day.